In a story breaking in just the last hour, Australia's energy crisis is escalating tonight, with the national market operator taking the enormous step of suspending trade on the wholesale electricity spot market. What does that mean? Well, it puts our energy bosses in direct control of our power supply from generator to grid. They say if they hadn't done it, it would be impossible to guarantee supply.
Cabinet in coal country. The Prime Minister visiting one of Australia's biggest energy users, which is going green, but it's the threat of blackouts for half the country in the spotlight.
We've got some big issues to deal with.
Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria and South Australia are tonight on alert.
Load shedding and blackouts are unlikely, but continues under very active management.
By the Australian energy market operator, AEMO, which last night intervened and directed 5,000 megawatts into the market, staving off forecast outages on the east coast.
The market is falling apart before our eyes because of market failure.
Some generators stopped bidding on the market when a wholesale price cap was triggered, leading to electricity shortfalls.
There should be no reason why there are power outages. That's just the big power companies gaming the system. But the long-term issue is the price issue.
We investigate them. If we find that they did not have adequate cause for withdrawing their capacity from the market, we will take action.
And late this afternoon, it did. AEMO taking the huge step of suspending the electricity spot market until further notice. And that means the market operators in total control of directing supplies from generators to the grid. It's never happened on a national scale before.
That visibility will help us to manage the system in real time, as well as to understand the balance of supply and demand.
But doesn't guarantee it'll keep the lights on.
Conditions remain tight in the coming days.
New South Wales in particular urged to conserve energy tonight. We're safe to do so. Chloe Bouris for 10 News First.